Nick, you had a point.
I put the blinds on too, because she said that when she came in. Do you get a point? If I didn't put the blind date.
I think we want blind date.
We want blind date.
Called out, introduced by a girl.
You say blind date. So what do you think? I think we're thinking blind date. We're blind one, blind date. When did they get engaged? No. Thank you. That's right. Thank you.
Like the teacher thing.
How long has Elizabeth been teaching?
3 years. So that's probably how I first got into the, or kind of was
promising me, but she's become a really good friend, and I'm so excited for Dan and Elizabeth. I was here after she came home from the first date with him, so it's been fun to hear all about Dan and then to meet him, and I just love Dan, so he's a wonderful guy, and I'm so excited for him. So, there we go, that's how I know her. You, Julie?
I'm Julie, and I've known Elizabeth since we were in junior high. We went to high school together, and then we went to Biola together, and so just kind of hung out, and I've been very familiar with this house.
We were roommates for We were roommates.
The best roommate that I ever had. I had lots of
good
roommates.
So far, Julie was the
most We had a good roommate, Kevin and I.
So far.
That's a roommate for life. So, how I know this?
Well, I am Elizabeth's sister-in-law, for those who don't know, and I met her first as when I was a music major, and I think you were a senior when I was freshman. So I was amazed by her gorgeous sound, and didn't really get to know her too much because we were so far apart, but then started dating her brother and got to know her through that, and it's just been so exciting for Ben and I to watch the relationship grow from having sparks they're a wonderful couple and it's a great example to us. And we just love spending time with them. So.
Maybe you should tell them about the sparks conversation.
Okay. So it was so great because I don't know, it's been a few weeks, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. And they've been going on quite a few dates and she just came home one night and was pretty down and asked us, you know, well, did you guys have sparks, you know, like on your, when did you guys find out that you had actually sparks, or when did that happen? And Ben was like, well, what did he say? Like, we had,
no.
Joe said first.
You said,
we had sparks on our first day.
Yeah. Yes, they're everything. Joe's like, Christina, I have sparks on the track. We'll be laughing about that.
And then Sam's laying on the ground.
Yeah, Sam's just relaxed. He's like, sparks are overrated. And then just, I think it was a few weeks later, just really soon after that, Ben had come home, and he found a note.
Yeah.
I think he read him, and it said, I have sparks now. And we were really excited for them. It was really neat. Great.
Okay. I'm Shasta, and I'm married to Ben. So I just grew up with the Oars playing baseball and soccer, and that's how I got to know them. Yeah. And Dan, great guy, and my husband really likes him.
And
I like
Oars. And the Oars of my future husband, but they play Xbox.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. They're bonding time.
Yeah.
My name is Katie, and I met Elizabeth in college, I think, and then at Hume Lake. After that, we knew each other for a little while, and then by God's amazing working, it worked out where I had a really good friend that Mark worked with that we knew that Elizabeth would be good with, and it just so happened to work out. So it was kind of neat.
Yeah.
It that we're really excited.
Katie said Dan and I am.
Good.
Hi. Elizabeth and Fanny. And I think they've been going together a couple of months, about 2 months. And we were very happy from that moment, and we are very happy for them both.
I'm Melinda, and I met Elizabeth at Biola. We were music majors together. And I think we might have had a couple of classes together and
yeah,
things like that, but I think we really met through our friend Destiny and got to know each other a little bit. And then, of course, I work with Catherine, so I've had a couple of contacts with her, and I really like Elizabeth, and
we had the same photographer for
yeah,
our wedding.
Yeah, that's right.
That's how I found
but,
it when you're ready.
Yeah, we do. And I really like Elizabeth, and I admire her honesty and her openness, and I really appreciate the things that I've heard about Dan, and I think you guys have a great life together. Mm-hmm.
I met Elizabeth in college, and kind of got to know each other a little bit then, and then she ended up volunteering in my husband's ministry. Sorry, my name is Sarah. Forgot that part. My husband was a high school pastor down at Grace Brethren Church in Long Beach, and Elizabeth MBSN Most Valuable Staff Member for her tenure there. And it was really neat to see her get to know my husband and to get to know her better myself and just kind of become friends through that in a little bit more intimate way. And then got to meet Dan fairly shortly after you guys started dating, and it was so fun to watch Elizabeth's face as she looked at Dan, and then to watch Dan's face as she looked at Elizabeth, as he looked at Elizabeth. So really excited.
Well, I'm Rachel. I'm the cousin to Elizabeth, and I think that one of the things that I remember with Elizabeth that was more recent, I don't know how long you guys were dating, but she came up from Valencia one night for dinner, and she met myself and my roommate, and she kind of, oh, I'm kind of dating somebody, and I just remember flat out just being like, all right, are you, like, what do you think? Like, is this serious? Do you think he's married? And she was like, yeah, I think he's the one, and I just remember thinking, I never doubted it, and I just was like, this, for her to say that, I knew this guy had to be great. And so I was just waiting for the wedding to come, and so this has been a long time for me. I'm really excited, and I think it's going to be a really great thing for her. I'm very excited.
I'm Debbie. I'm the aunt. I'm actually married to Elizabeth's uncle, Steve, her brother, her father's brother. And I think Steve and I were one of the first to kind of run into you guys on a date at downtown Disney.
We kept running into people
now. we were out for a night out without our daughter and cruising along, and it was like, all of a sudden, there's Elizabeth and wow. And so we were really cool about it, though. We didn't, like, react or anything. Well, hi, Elizabeth, and perfectly normal all the time. But Steve has always said he has a special Christmas card for Bessie Sue. I couldn't figure out who that was, so I know it was Elizabeth. So, for Bessie Sue.
That's
all
right. Very
That's right.
I love that you guys are here. I'm so excited.
My name is Larissa, and I met Dan in school, which is how I met Elizabeth when we gave a shower for another one of our classmates who just had a baby. So that's what I met Elizabeth. I've heard her name, but I didn't see her.
Because they didn't think I was real until I showed up.
No, we kept promising, you guys are going to meet her. You guys are going to meet her. And I'm like, Dan, your wedding is June. We're going to meet her. We kind of like to know before the wedding.
Well, I'm Diane, and I'm also a bold classmate of Dan. And Dan is this really sweet man. Dan is nothing like you would think a seasoned police officer would be sitting in class. He's nothing like an unmarried bachelor, you think, sitting in class. He was like, you're kidding, and this one's like still out there? Such a sweet man. And he told me months and months ago, oh, I have someone very special. And that's about all he said, because when we're in class, it is 4 hours of very intense work. But when it came to for all of us to be together, and we were going to have a baby shower, and I said, oh, this is a couple shower. We want to really get to know each other and put faces to spouses or whoever we're going with. Dan was so proud. Oh, he couldn't wait to get there. And really and truly, all of us women really wanted to check Elizabeth out. They wanted to see who had turned Dan's head like that. And you know what? I'm just so thankful that Elizabeth is who she is, because he's a very sweet man, and he deserves somebody as wonderful as
him. Amen.
Me? Oh, hi. I'm Rose Brandon. I'm in the Sudbury group with Dan, and I met Elizabeth through Dan. I can maybe have a right.
That's it.
Okay.
I think I know I am. I have a Elizabeth's younger sister, and that's it.
Only sister.
Three years, I was like, born on my third birthday.
Oh.
Yeah.
I'll tell you a story. Oh. One time, Elizabeth had gone out with Dan
once or twice, maybe, and he was kind of not really sure and wondered what this was going to turn into. And we were driving down to the store, and she said, well, I just don't know. And then she started telling me all these things she liked about him. And all these, she named about six things off, and then she said, I'm going to just give it another good chance here. And she did, and I'm really glad she did, because I've never seen two people that look like they go together, and they act like they go together, and they just have a really great time together, and they know they're going to have a great life serving the Lord together and raising a godly family. And really looking forward to that.
Because we asked Dan questions, so you'll get the opportunity to see Dan answer these questions on video.
Oh.
Them, and then we'll see what kind of thing. We'll see if they give the same answer.
I'm going to have a hard time living next to Lindsay in bed. You got them all right.
She did. That was good.
So here
it goes.
How was your first day of rain? How did you feel about it? And how did Dan feel about it?
Okay. Our first date was arranged because Katie works with my mom, and both Dan and I were going through kind of lonely times, but we were ready to, you know, have family or look for somebody. So they thought it was kind of unusual, and Katie thought that we should maybe try to go on a date. So I actually was open, which is very uncharacteristic of me, since I've been on like 2 dates in my whole life to go on a blind date. That was out of my comfort zone, to say the least. But we went on the double date, and Dan was really nervous or something. I could tell he was a really quality guy, and then the fact that Katie recommended him to me, I think that played actually the biggest part in me really sticking with it and not falling back into my comfort zone for a while, because I trusted her judgment. So the first date, I mean, it's a hard situation because you skip all the friendship part of dating and go right to the romantic part, and it's hard. And so I felt like I got to know a lot of good qualities about him, good things, and it was fun to see him and Mark react to it with each other. I felt like I probably wasn't going to go out with him again after the first date. And I haven't told him that all the way yet.
You don't know what he was thinking either.
I don't think he felt fully like, yeah, I'm in love either. But I think we both recognized, redeeming qualities in each other and knew that it was worth a second try, and it was.
That looks like Sam.
Oh, wait,
it's after Sam. After this hit.
There we go.
Good guy.
Sorry, this is part of our life too.
And then jump to the end of the
ball.
There it goes.
Okay, question number one. How was your first date arranged, and how did you feel about it, and how did Elizabeth feel about it?
My first date was arranged by one of my friends, Mark. That's how I found out about it. But Mark and Katie, and
told me about Elizabeth, and I emailed her, so I emailed, and then I came up with the idea to go to Disneyland, all four of us, to kind of break the ice. So that's how we met.
How did you feel about it after the date?
I felt good about it. It was fun. I had a good time. And when I brought Elizabeth back home and talked to Katie afterwards when we were going back over to their house, she was curious. So she said, "Oh, what do you think?" And I was like, "Oh, I like her." And she was all giddy and excited.
You were.
I know what attracted me to Dan. It's an easier question first, though. The fact that he's there's so many things. It's really hard. I mean, it's hard to choose. I think one of the first things is he's a policeman, and so that was the first thing that really attracted me to him, because he was a public servant, which I was too as a teacher, and so that was really appealing. It showed me kind of where his heart was a little bit. I think mostly, though, he was a very considerate person. I think that was the first thing that I really fell in love with. Mm-hmm. He was so polite, and so he listened, and he would always consider what other people thought and make them comfortable, mm-hmm. make them feel at ease, and that was really attractive. So. And then what did he like about me? I think he liked, I mean, too, my occupation, I think, was an attraction to him, a teacher, but probably that my kindness, maybe? I don't know. I'm a kind person, I think. I'm kind of the same, I think in some ways you have the same strength in that way.
Turn it up, Kevin.
After that, for a couple of days, but later on, we talked about it. She said it was kind of awkward. She thought I was a little goofy, so I don't think she digged it as much as I did.
This is never the end of
the book. What was one thing that attracted you to Elizabeth?
Oh, the first thing that attracted me to Elizabeth was her smile and her laugh.
I would have guessed that.
Right away.
When did you know that you loved Elizabeth?
When did you know that you went to work?
When do you think he knew that you were?
I think for some reason we went to Baker to Vegas, which is this race that all the law enforcement ran, and Dan was a medic in it, and so we went on a road trip to Las Vegas, and it sounds really trivial, but we went to Del Taco on the way there, and I wrapped up this food and made it so that he could eat it and drive at the same time, and I think that was really, like, important to him that I could be a good road trip person. I said I learned it from my mom. But I think that trip, when you're with someone for an extended period of time, you really learn if you can live with them, and so I think, I mean, that's the first time he told me he loved me, but he said he wanted to tell me before, but so I would say that was about 3 months in our relationship when we went to Vegas.
About 3 months, 30 days, 3 months, and that was around Valentine's Day, and I bought a rose and stuff.
Yeah. I'm here when he asked him to be his girlfriend.
What did you think of Elizabeth's family the first time?
They're huge.
He was probably very nervous because everybody was outside in the front yard when he drove up. And I think I remember him saying that he thought we were very friendly and he felt pretty comfortable given the present situation. He liked my family a lot. I thought they were very nice.
Oh, that was kind of interesting because they were the whole family was here when I came over for the first date. So when I drove up to meet her, Coach was out there watering the lawn and she kind of walked up the driveway and then Pat came out and Jill and Ben and everybody was in it. So they came out and I met everybody right away and kind of introduce myself.
And
I was like, okay, bye.
And what's the, just a fun question, what's the code like for a CHP officer to call for backup? We just wondered if you knew.
There's so many of them. Okay, well, I do know he went into the academy, he went right away when he turned 21, he wanted to do that. And that's the earliest you can be admitted. And then I think he's in his sixth year. Wait, 29, 23. Yeah, I think 6 years. Maybe going on a seventh. Okay, that's my answer for that. And then I don't know his code.
Make one up.
Oh, I did. I used to say 1040 or something. And that was my code because he's like, that doesn't mean anything.
He doesn't know anything about that either.
You know, actually, that's kind of appropriate. That will be his 10th
one. I started in the academy in October 96, and the night I was playing in South LA in March 97, so 5.5 years almost.
It's one of those kids that looks
up. We're in math right now.
It's one of those kids that looks up in the air to find
the answer.
If you're calling for backup.
Backup? Well, if it's an emergency, but it's not a life-threatening emergency, it's 1035.
But
if it's a number like a life-threatening emergency, it's 1039.
What code is your wife ready to deliver?
What's your favorite restaurant to go to?
We love Baja Fresh, I think. And we like Quen Jumper.
I mean,
when did you know that you wanted to get married? You said, I asked Dan a question.
Yeah.
When did he know he wanted to get married?
When did he know he wanted to get married? Well, probably. I'll try again. The biggest trip.
The Del Taco
moment, right?
Yeah.
The Del Taco moment.
Maybe between September and October, but I actually started thinking about it seriously in October.
Okay, I'm wrong again.
October.
I don't think you
How did the Emperor vote?
Okay, I have the story online if you want to read it. That's how I told my students they're doing autobiographical writing, and so I did an example of autobiographical incident, and I did it on the overhead, and they got to the end, and they're like, oh, is it true? Is it true? Yes! So, so I did write it all out, and it's kind of fun if you want to read it, but I'll tell it a short version. Dan's family was over for Thanksgiving,
And I had wanted to get engaged a long time before that. But there was, you know, a lot of stuff going on in the family then. Lindsay got married in October, and we had only been dating 11 months, so I thought I could wait. And so I really didn't think we were going to get engaged anytime within that time period. We were after dinner, the big bright fluorescent and green minivan pulled up, and it was the Conroy minivan, and someone yelled, "Look, the flower truck is here!" And Deborah's like, "Who gave flowers?" You know, and Joe's like, "And Joe, did you send flowers to Christy?" And, you know, everybody's trying to guess, and I saw Dan sitting by his mom, and you were, trying to keep you quiet. And so I knew it was calling for me, and I thought, oh, they're in honor of Thanksgiving, or, you know, just like Dan, do something romantic. And I seriously didn't think anything of it. So the flowers come, the beautiful red, white roses with lemon leaves, and I'm like, oh, thanks, Dan, thanks. And I'm hugging him, and he's like, read the card. He's like, no, read the card. I'm like, oh, he's so insistent about the card. So I get it out, and it says, I think partially I kind of didn't want to read the card. You know how that feels? When you just want to go slow and enjoy the moment. Yeah. So it said, will you? And then I turned around, and Sam yelled, whoa, look at that. He had a lighted ring box, so it had a little light in it, and it's shining on my ring, and then he was on his knee. He said, will you marry me? And everybody cheered. It was so fun because it was in front of all my family, my immediate family.
They really liked the box.
Yeah. I passed it around at school. I students wanted to see the box. So it was a very fun day.
I came up with this plan to propose around Thanksgiving when both of our families were together, and it was totally a surprise. So I actually had a harder time trying to set up asking Coach for his blessing than it was to propose, because I could never, you know, just sit down and talk with him without kind of letting him figure it out. So I walked with him over by all of the went over to get some stuff at the school, and then I asked him, and then I came up with this plan to ask Elizabeth on Thanksgiving as a surprise. So what I did was I called a couple weeks ahead of time to a flower shop, and I told them to deliver the flowers on Thanksgiving in the afternoon. And I already had the ring all picked out and everything, and I brought it with me, and I hid it in my pocket. And I knew the flowers were going to show up sometime in the afternoon, so as soon as the flowers got here, the card had "Will you" written on it. And then when she read the card, I know I was going to propose the whole thing. So the flowers got here, and everybody was all excited, and nobody knew who the flowers were for. And then finally the guy said, "No, these are for Elizabeth." And when she went over there to get the flowers, she was happy to get the flowers, and me, and she didn't read the card right away. She read the crazy card. That's part of the plan. And so finally she read the card, and then I got the ring out while she wasn't looking and got down on my knee. And then after she read the card, she turned around and looked at me, but I didn't close her.
I wrote him a lot of letters and notes. The first present I get, it was his birthday, I think, and it was in March 10th, is his birthday, and I gave him, I had a hard time, thought it was too big of a present for how short we were dating, but it was a watch, the next watch. Manny watch.
I had been talking about getting a watch, and she was kind of asking, well, what kind of watch? And I was surprised when I didn't know that she was going to get it. I've been looking at a couple different kinds of watches. And I showed up on my list.
Last question.
Yeah.
most memorable times together?
Don't try Vegas again.
Okay, third time.
You guys having too much fun doing all this stuff on that show.
Most memorable time together.
Most memorable?
Probably.
Yeah, there's a lot. Our trip to Seattle was a lot of fun. Catalina was fun. Probably, we had a really good time in Las Vegas. Yeah!
She wrapped my
burrito for me.
We
got stuck
on the way back, so we had a lot of time to talk. We were racing back for traffic
to Seattle. Is there anything else you'd like to share, or any other
stories? No.
Thank you, Dan. We're
stuck in traffic.
Huh?
We're stuck in
traffic.
I couldn't hear what he said.
We were stuck in traffic, and we were trying to get back for Catherine's recital.
Oh,
it was really stressed out. Yeah. I told him if we missed that, I'd never be forgiven.
Oh.
I know I would be. That's how I would feel. I
Great. I think before we open presents and kind of we can get some more food, we just like to pray for Elizabeth and Dan and, you know, thanks for their engagement and then their marriage. And, yeah, I think what a blessing it is, and then I think, I'm not married, but just I think when two people come together, like just the day-to-day living, I think being growing up in the church, you know it's hard, or that you know the man's supposed to be the leader of the home, and I think for a wife to be that helper to do it, and so I think that's something that I will, you know, continue to pray for. That you can be a helper and supporter, and that you guys will be a team together. And I think that's so exciting to be able to be marrying someone and to be so excited to know that this person is going to help you and complete you. And you guys will be more effective, hopefully, together, and I know you will, than you would be apart. And so, yeah, if a couple of you just want to pray for them, then I will close.
Dear God, we just thank you so much for being an amazing and awesome God and just the ways that you work. And Lord, I just praise you so much for Dan and Elizabeth and just what precious people they are, Lord. And I just pray as they get closer to their wedding and as their wedding day comes, Lord, that you just bless every moment of it and that they remember that it's a marriage that they're starting. And please help them just to encourage each other and just love each other with all their hearts, God, and that they can just serve you with all their hearts. And we just thank you so much for them. We just pray that you bless them and help their wedding day just to be a really special one for them. You're precious.
Dear Lord, just thank you so much that we can have this special time where we can just all get together, friends and family, just to celebrate this time and where Elizabeth and Dan have found each other, and that you bless them and with love, and just help us to be an encourager to their marriage, mm-hmm. and to remember to pray for them and to be helpers, and just thank you so much for what you've done in all our lives and in Elizabeth and Dan's lives.
Lord, we praise you for the creation of marriage and for the way that you have knit two hearts into one. You really become one with the person that you've known for a relatively short period of time. God, what an amazing picture that is of your love for us and your sacrificial desire to protect and to serve us. And we are so honored that you have let us experience in some way the love that you have for your body. And God, I just praise you for the way that you have brought Dan and Elizabeth together in your perfect timing, that you have been preparing their hearts for each other, and that you're going to continue to do that, that it is not just
why we come to you today. I'm so excited to be able to celebrate in the Little Sisters. We're just thankful for them and for just how we know them, the friendship that they have, that we've had with them. We're just so excited because they are two servants of you who are following you daily, and how exciting that is. And they can get married and more together be a team, and to go out in the world for whatever you have for them to do. Lord, may they be able to serve you together. Be an encouragement to each other, Lord, be a support to each other. We just pray for that in this next month and then in the years to come, Lord. Would you just help them encourage each other? Help them strengthen each other. And may they keep their eyes on you. And again, we just thank you for this coming and the friends and the family that are here to celebrate it. Happy things in your name.
I think we're going to have a time to have you open your presents.
Jungle living room. Because some of my palm trees died, I need to get some new ones. Oh, sure. We might as well pass them over. Would you like to look at the bowl? Those are nice. Yeah, we can.
Yeah. Hey, these are from.
What is that?
They're like little charms you put on your glasses. Oh. You know how you have your green glasses?
Oh, yeah.
I
thought they were so cute.
Yeah.
Oh.
I love these. I thought, I know we don't drink wine, but we still know we can't drink out of beautiful glasses.
We still need to know who they are.
Yeah.
Oh, these are really cute.
Thank you. I'm really excited about our honeymoon.
Yay! I knew glasses, and everybody knows which glasses they're.
I know.
Like on your goblets, you know?
Where are you going?
I bet they just open up and then they put them on.
So you're going to Maui for 12
They don't waste all their
glasses. Oh, I know.
Oh,
sure. You have all that vacation. Yeah, it's true. I guess he didn't go on vacation for the first 5 years of work either, and so he just told me in the day, like hundreds of days of vacation. Oh, not hundreds, but a lot. Oh, this is my aunt. Did she write her name?
Yes, she did.
Wow, she's got some fancy writing. I have one of her old pictures. She drew me up in my office, so
Break the bow.
The tradition is for every ribbon broken, that's the number of children. So if you break two ribbons on one, then that's twins.
Twins run in our family.
Yeah. Twins run in both sides of our family. My niece had twins, and now she's having twins again. Yeah. That's what you can put your little animals on those.
Thank you so much. Yeah.
Those little blocks.
Yeah. Yeah. Dan's the meat man too, because I tried to make one night for dinner, we decided we were going to make meat, and I said, I can make my own meat. He's like, okay, just come on and marinate.
Do you want me to pass these? Do you want to look at them after?
Yeah,
okay.
My meat was not very good.
I'll leave them right here, and then you can come in.
Matthew makes the meat, and I make everything.
Works well that way.
Thank you. Nice that I already have a house to register for things for.
So nice.
I know exactly
know what that
how much room
look
and
like.
And he has this really neat windowsill right where over the kitchen sink when I grow my herbs right there. They're all dead right now because he doesn't water anything when I'm not there.
I came to school the other day.
This is Dan. He really wanted us to
one thing or the other. He's kind of a gadget guy, huh?
Yeah, for when you make turkey or
thanks, Sarah. Oh, your own apple singer. That's good.
Rachel's a bride to be too. She's getting married 1 month after me.
And she has an interesting story.
Yeah.
You really should tell that one before we leave.
Thanks, Rachel.
Wow, that material looks like heavenly. Don't worry, we'll make you try something else.
I know this color.
No. Does she ever?
Soul Fairy is the name of the bold class. It's really neat how they keep everybody
so,
together.
Now what does that mean?
Well, they do it so they have camaraderie.
Oh.
They come in, whoever starts bold at the same time graduates this way, and they take all their classes together. It's the same people.
So what
is
really
named after a tree on
actually
campus.
A tree on
oh, okay.
Yeah. All the campuses, there's five campuses, they name all of their classes after whatever trees are planted around.
Oh, that's neat.
Trees.
So I heard you guys were asking Dan what favorite his favorite color was. Like, he kept asking me what my favorite color was.
Oh.
Yeah. I learned that from one of my roommate, Holly. She taught me how to smell good.
Now, Larissa did all the picking.
Oh.
She was on a mission.
We were just looking at this book.
What is it?
The Power of a Praying Wife. You recommended this to me, huh?
Yeah.
Thanks. That's an important part of being a wife. So I hear. And then he said red, didn't he? Yeah.
Wow.
Pretty sexy.
You bold people are pretty bold.
Cool color. So you're telling me you got that as a
bonus? Hi, there's more.
Cool colors. I like that one.
And then black.
I already gave him the time.
And I have you know, God held that there because my window store lady said, we don't have red after February. There's nothing red in the store. And she went to go look for something else for me, and I was like, ah, what's that? Right side, okay, it's mine. The guy was looking at it for a girlfriend, and I snatched it. And I told the lady, put it behind the counter.
It'll be the one thing. Thank you, guys.
I'll have to be sure to tell Dan when I'm wearing that where it came from.
Oh, no. That'll
be an interesting mood.
The women I take glasses with bosses for you.
Actually, I thought maybe wait till your honeymoon and then when you wear it, then tell them.
Yeah, okay. No, oh, this is from Holly. Holly lives in Chicago. She said that to you? Oh. Holly was one of my roommates, the one who taught me how to smoke it. She seriously had like 15 kinds of lotion. And
Lindsay, that's your favorite singer. When Lindsay and Ben got married, Ben picked out some stuff out of the catalog for Lindsay. It was bright purple.
Oh no.
Funny to see I'm going to the Victoria's Secret catalog.
Yeah. They make noise, you know, like her class. Julie! She says, remember you asked for wild. Have fun. it's not very heavy.
It's not flannel.
And I see a little fur.
Oh, no. Fur.
This is not perfect. You guys know that elephants are my favorite animals, right?
I totally forgot that.
Wait, now what exactly is that? That's kind of what I thought, but. Mothers make their moves.
Wow, that is pretty wild.
Good job.
I'm sorry.
Pass that one around. Yes, there it is. Okay. And here's your mother holding it. Oh, Julie.
Now, you guys have some fun little stuff. Don't tell them, but, you know. Back from the honeymoon, then you guys can say something. Yeah.
Well, I'm not going there. You're not even going
to ask. No, I feel like you're going to get them sometime.
I know.
That's right.
Thanks, Justin. Did you make that card? Mm-hmm. Wow, so crafty.
You know us primary people.
Well, this is feathers.
Oh, my goodness. Justin.
Yeah, didn't you get like a Santa outfit? You got married Christmas
time. Wow.
There you go.
Oh, feathers floating around.
That's effective.
Well, then this didn't work out quite right. Well, it worked out now, but I meant to get the book they got, but when I opened it up, it was a study guide.
It's a study guide.
But now you can have a study guide.
Oh.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Thank the Lord. All right.
so like I can write my feelings down and stuff as I read it.
Too bad you're not closer, Rich. You guys can have a Bible study.
I know. I know.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Over the internet.
Yeah. So this is the top to me.
Uh-huh. Right. Oh, that's really a neat thing.
Yeah.
Can
you go
along
with that jungle
one? Yeah.
Thank you, guys. Oh, there's more. Anyway, see y'all. Christy.
Yeah.
Waiting suspensefully, huh?
Really hard.
Wow.
Really?
Oh.
Oh.
Yeah, it's
tricky.
Sexy and yet covered.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's how it goes with a lot.
or a little.
When I'm
traveling.
Is it from
Catherine?
Yeah, I think it is. From my sister.
White down the top. Holly told me, get a lot of these because they really like those.
You could always start a card company.
Yeah. Yeah. So when you get my invitations in the mail, my brother made those, so he designed them.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Wow. Ooh.
Oh, wow.
Oh.
Really?
Oh.
Scary.
Oh, that's cool.
Thanks.
Captain, could you get mine? Because it's more than the bed. The next to my bed.
Hey, I just signed up for this. Did you see it on my register?
No.
Yeah, I went back and added it because I went and I didn't have so many cookbooks. So it's Better Home Things. Yeah, that's what they said on the online. They said this is the number one cookbook for 40 years or something like that.
You have a present coming behind you. It's red.
Oh. From you? Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mom.
You have to open it, and then you have to open it, and then you have to open it if you want to get to the last present.
That's
very
well.
It's called prolonging the fun.
Do I open these?
You have to open the big suitcase. No.
Big suitcase.
And then
you remember in Hawaii that you have to lift your own suitcase onto, it's leaving Hawaii. There's an agricultural thing you have to go through now, and you have to hoist your own suitcase.
Yeah.
And I'll make it too heavy.
Right.
Okay.
I don't think they're not going to weigh that.
Let me weigh in very nice anything. That bathing suit should not be
that. Now you have to open that one.
Okay, I get it now.
It's like those nesting dolls.
No more flower luggage.
No more flower luggage. Yeah, well, I have bright blue, and it really is easy to find.
Ooh.
Okay.
This is very brightish.
Right. I liked the hanger. He was free with the nightgown. Another thing in there, too.
There's four?
Yeah.
Do I have to keep those?
No, I think it's in the other. It's in one of those zippers. I don't know. I think it's in one of those zippers. The front one, maybe?
Oh,
yeah.
Oh.
Thank you.
Yay! I'm ready now. That's all you need.
When she walked out with one little box filled up and it's just been unpacked.
That's all we could.
I'm so excited. That's amazing.